There was one day in 1975 when I came home and I told my father that, you know, I don't think I want to be a doctor practicing regular medicine. I want to be somebody who does science. We had nothing. We were poor. We were immigrants. And he thought that toiling away in a laboratory was not necessarily a great path towards success. And he was disappointed that I didn't want to become a real doctor. The next day, he had cut out an article from the Greek newspaper. He says to me, well, if you're going to become a scientist, so I'm getting a little emotional here. If you want to become a scientist, don't just become any scientist. Become like this man. And it was an article in 1975 about Roy Vagelos leaving academia to become head of R&D at Merck. And basically, you know, told me this should be my role model. I should be like Roy.
Roy comes from a family of Greek immigrants. His parents came here. He was born in New Jersey. He grew up in a family that was really dedicated to serving others. His mother was a seamstress, and his father and his uncles opened a business to serve sweets to other restaurants, and then started a diner where Roy worked as a busboy. And I think the legend of Roy Vagelos begins with the story that at that time, he served scientists, engineers, and chemists from Merck, listening to their stories about what science could do. Roy, coming to Columbia after being at the University of Pennsylvania, started a new chapter in his life of pursuing science, of understanding how science could transform human health. But it also was a chapter for his family. It was here in Washington Heights and Columbia that he met Diana. Diana was a student at Barnard, had grown up in Washington Heights, and the team that came out of that has been second to none. From Columbia, Roy went to the Massachusetts General Hospital, a place that was leading and thinking about how to bring physicians and science together. And it was from there that he went to the National Institutes of Health.
What's so wonderful about NIH is that for those who are there, there's only one goal: improve the health of people everywhere. While at NIH, Roy Vagelos started off spending half of his time taking care of heart patients and the other half doing research in biochemistry. He worked with some legends of our field. The biochemist, Earl Stadman, who had previously never worked with a medical doctor, and later with the microbial geneticist, Jacques Monod. Dr. Vagelos' fundamental research on lipid metabolism led to the discovery of the acyl carrier protein, one of a number of his major contributions over his impressive career.
Roy left the NIH to chair the Department of Biochemistry and established the Division of Biology and Biomedical Sciences at Washington University's School of Medicine in St. Louis. Roy and Diana made St. Louis their home. In an amazing story that has come full circle, Roy was recruited to lead the Merck Research Laboratory he had long admired while working behind the counter of his family's luncheonette. Under his leadership, Merck made so many of the transformative medicines that we rely upon today. Medicines like the statin.
As we all know now, statins are one of the most important drugs in history.
Roy Vagelos, to me, embraces a deep commitment to equality and social justice.
You know, people talk about corporate social responsibility today and the role of corporations in meeting society's needs. Let's go back to the mid-1980s. At that time, Roy Vagelos was the CEO of Merck. They invented what was then the largest animal health product in history. It was called ivermectin. And Roy and his colleagues were curious about whether this medicine, which works so effectively for cattle, would actually work on a terrible disease called river blindness.
River blindness is caused by a parasite called onchocerciasis, and this condition largely affects millions and millions of people in Africa, in Latin America, and in the Middle East as well.
What they learned is that we could use a form of that drug, one pill per patient per year.
And then that's what really caused him to say, we have a drug, we know it works, and we should not deny a population just because they can't afford it. And so he stepped up and committed that Merck would provide Mectazan for as long as was needed until we eliminated river blindness. And actually, that pledge continues to this day. Merck stepped up because Roy stepped up. And he did it not only once, he did it multiple times. In the other example, we had a drug. It was one of the first recombinant vaccines that had ever been developed to fight hepatitis B, which at the time was a terrible pandemic within China.
At that time, the People's Republic of China didn't have the resources to actually pay for the vaccine. And Roy said, okay, this is another example of where Merck can take an action on its own that's not required, that can alleviate human suffering on a broad scale.
What Roy did, I think, set the stage for a whole new way of thinking about our commitment to the world. When the history of global health is written, I think his contribution will be very profound and will always be notable because of the magnitude of the impact, but I think also because he set the stage for thinking differently and doing differently.
When I think of people retiring and playing golf without any positive impact on society, it is such a loss for all of us. I guess my advice is, let's do away with golf and allow people to continue productive careers, because the world will be a lot better.
I was supposed to present everything that we were doing. He wanted to spend the whole day with me. By the end of that first day, I was sweating bullets. He was like, come with questions out of left field, and he was catching me on all sorts of things. But luckily, Roy was very interested in what we were doing, and he thought that we had the possibility of maybe becoming the next great company. You know, and the rest, as they say, is history.
You know, we had our first departmental retreat in many years this past fall, and Roy sat in the front row with a notebook, and he took notes during every single seminar. And I don't think I can say that for any of my colleagues that were even at the retreat.
It's a delight to see him and Diana on campus. It's a pure joy. But probably most importantly, he also keeps me on my toes.
I would just say that Roy keeps me on my toes. You never know when I might get a call or an email saying, oh, can we discuss something? I better be prepared for those conversations.
The Vagelos effect is contagious. When you spend 3 minutes talking to either of them and you want to be like them, you want to start giving, you want to contribute, you want to share.
It only takes a minute or two of being around Roy and Diana to understand what Pied Pipers they are, to understand that they lead and others join. It was Roy and Diana's ability to bring others along that really helped advance this vision for medical education transformation.
It's transformational. It's transformational in medical education nationwide.
A lot of students are discouraged from applying into medical school because of the financial implications.
Both Roy and I were scholarship students, and we have appreciated that forever.
By enabling medical students to complete their education loan-free, Roy and Diana sparked a revolution across the country. The best students can take on whatever career they want. They can become a scientist, a primary care doctor. They can give back in the way that they believe.
And the data shows that it allows for representation of all students, of all people, to seek an extraordinary education here.
It's been amazing to see how he has really thought so carefully about his giving and how he has really focused on just the right things.
The recognition of the inordinate power of the sequence of the human genome led Roy to be a founding supporter of Columbia's program in precision medicine.
I have ended every one of my acknowledgement statements with a thank you to the generous support from the Vagelos Precision Medicine Fund. It's behind every single breakthrough we've had because we had the backing of Roy and Diana to make it happen.
The construction of the Vagelos Center and the Diana Center, educational, intellectual, and social hubs of both Barnard and Columbia.
Like many kids in their generation, my kids are very concerned and worried about climate change and the environment. Roy, of course, very early on recognized that this is truly an existential threat.
And now Roy and Diana have come together again to set a new standard. This gift, the creation of the Vagelos Institute for Biomedical Science, builds upon their commitment to graduate education and the training of physician scientists to conduct science that crosses boundaries, that leverages the latest technologies, whether those be new ways of sequencing or the revolution in artificial intelligence. This gift will mean that we have the leading scientific ecosystem. Perhaps most importantly, though, this gift reflects Roy and Diana's commitment to the future and to future generations.
I think the most important thing about someone like Roy Vagelos is that it doesn't end with Roy. His legacy is that he's inspired now generations of people to try to live up to his example.
Roy is a tremendous role model. He's a tremendous role model for me. He's a tremendous role model for my colleagues and really for the entire Columbia community. He has this deep understanding of how science pushes discovery and how discovery is essential for really state-of-the-art patient care.
You know, Roy for me is a role model, not just for how to lead on the scientific vision, but how to make sure that those outcomes are spread and disseminated in a way that can reach patients.
He really is the thing that many of our learners just don't see every day. He is a first-generation college student. It's extraordinary to see him with a group of learners, first-generation and low-income learners, who come and seek his counsel. Just about like, do I deserve to be here? And he goes, of course.
Thank you, Dr. Vagelos. Your charity, your generosity has really greatly affected my life and the life of many, and I really couldn't be any more ecstatic to pursue my medical education at Columbia.
I would say that I am very much looking forward to meeting you someday so I can shake both of your hands and thank you personally for the difference that you've made in my life and the difference you're making for hundreds of other students every single year. Thank you for what you've done for us.
Thank you, Dr. Vagelos and Diana. I'm hoping that I can become the best physician scientist here at Columbia, thanks to you guys.
No matter how old you are, you have heroes. Whether they're Superman, Wonder Woman, or my hero, the guy standing to my right, Roy Vagelos.
Roy and Diana are heroes in American medicine. But for those of us who work here at the school in their name, at the Vagelos College of Physicians and Surgeons, they're our friends, they're our partners. They are what make it all possible. They are the people who keep us going. He is our North Star. He helps us see where we should go. And Diana brings us there. She picks us up and carries us along. Together, they are the people who watch over us. I call them my fairy godparents. You know, every day, life is better because I wake up knowing that Roy and Diana are watching out for me. They're watching out for the school, and they're watching out for American medicine.
Our next anniversary will be our 70th. So we think that that's been a good, long, and fun run. And if anything, it's been an adventure, probably for both of us. We're always looking to find something we haven't done before, someone we haven't met before, something we haven't heard about before. So really, I think the word adventure is the best description I can give.
My hope for the future is that students from Columbia and everywhere else continue using their intellect to solve problems of society. I'm enormously optimistic if we allow those students to achieve their maximal capacity. That will really not only change the community, the places around us, but it will change the world.